tonight on an event as Wrestle Birmingham comes and returns to the Valhall Auditorium. History in this building of professional wrestling dating back 60 years.
What a night of wrestling it'll be. And as we go along tonight and get a chance to get deep into the tradition that is the National Wrestling Alliance and, of course, Wrestle Birmingham, the wrestler, I don't know what you know about him, parts unknown, Sonny Siaki on the other side, and look who's at ringside.
Oh, boy. The stud himself, Robert Fuller, the Tennessee stud, is instructing Sonny Siaki, and this is a bit of a surprise. Siaki, of course, has made quite a name of himself for himself in the past couple of years with NWA TNA. You've seen him on Fox television. You've seen him in a lot of pay-per-views, and he goes right to work on the masked man known as the wrestler. You know, Dan, there have been several masked men throughout the wrestling history known as the wrestler, and I guess this is the latest in the line, and this young man right now is being pounded on by Sonny Siaki. You see two sides of Sonny Siaki sometime. There's a good side, there's a bad side, and I think right now we're seeing the bad side.
I think Cocky Siaki is in full effect here tonight at the Botwell.
And he's got the wrestler up against the ropes.
Irish rip out now. Siaki down.
Nice hip toss takedown. Full slam by the wrestler, showing good power there. Siaki on the receiving end of the drop kick and onto the floor, and right away the Tennessee stud, Robert Fuller, complaining to referee Big Mike that the tights were pulled. And boy, what a way for Sonny Siaki to make his first appearance here in Wrestle Birmingham.
Getting a break on the outside, getting a little bit of fresh air.
You know, it's amazing to watch Robert Fuller, and knowing the history of his family and his famous father, the immortal Buddy Fuller, and now to see Robert as a manager and as someone who almost just has to have that control factor at all time, and now preying on the young talents of Sonny Siaki, who is definitely on the upper rise, if you would, of NWA wrestling throughout this area. And of course, it's great to have him here in Wrestle Birmingham, where they continue to bring both the young stars and the legends together for great wrestling action.
You never know who you're going to see at a Wrestle Birmingham. Walking around the back, all kinds of surprise guests that weren't even scheduled to be here. Kind of an added bonus for the fans.
You know, and talking about the NWA, which is has been the premier logo of professional wrestling for many a decade. New NWA champion, and to no surprise, I think this is the third or fourth time he's held the belt, and I'm talking about the chosen one, Jeff Jarrett, now holding the NWA belt once again.
And all these gentlemen here at Wrestle Birmingham, as they rise to the top, they've got to have their eyes set on that National Wrestling Alliance heavyweight title. Now, wait a minute, Sonny Siaki claiming their hair was pulled, but he doesn't have any.
Sonny, you got to come up with a better one than that on this.
That's not going to work with the people here at Wrestle Birmingham.
I'm anxious to talk. I'm going to see after this match if we can get an opportunity to speak with Robert Fuller and Sonny Siaki. I'm a little surprised to see Robert Fuller in Siaki's corner.
I'm not sure what the connection is between the two. I'm sure money's involved, and maybe you can find out from the horse's mouth, so to speak.
Well, Robert Fuller has never been one to back away from an opportunity, and of course, he is very opportunistic, and I think that is probably what's occurring in this match. Siaki and the wrestler lock it up again, collar and elbow, and the wrestler takes over with a standing arm bar and a twist, and Siaki goes down to the mat, and the wrestler drops over the front part of that forearm. And this is something, the wrestler almost to the old school talents and tactics of working the left side, and not a lot of aerial action, but keeping the event, keeping the match close to the mat.
I'm sure, you know, I don't know a lot about this wrestler and his history, but I'm willing to bet you he's been around for a long time.
And he is keeping the arm of Siaki neutralized. And you neutralize one of 4 points of the body, 5 points of the body, rather, and you got a good chance of winning the match. And that's, I think, what the wrestler is planning on doing here, is he's taking the match right to the young star, Sonny Siaki. You know, I wouldn't say that Siaki has reached superstar status yet, but in watching this man and having the opportunity to do some work with TNA a few years back when he first came on the scene, he has made tremendous strides in the squared circle.
From the Isles of Samoa, and Cocky Siaki right here with us at Wrestle Birmingham.
Here's the wrestler. There's a shoulder block. Siaki ducks down, catches him, reverse. Toss takedown, and again Siaki finding himself on the mat, and the stud Robert Fuller not real happy with the goings on in this match to this point, as he is fanning himself right now. Maybe it's getting a little too hot in the squared circle. This match coming to you from the Boutwell Auditorium, and I'll tell you, they have done a magnificent job in restoring this building, and if these walls can talk, you know, and having the opportunity to commentate professional wrestling here in the 70s and then again in the 80s, and now here in the new century in 2005, I can remember such vivid matches of the likes of Lynn Rossi and Tex Riley in this arena. Jackie Fargo, oh, nice move by Siaki. Caught him across the top of the head. Down goes the wrestler. Got a two count on that one. And to see the young stars now come up and have the opportunity to wrestle in this building, it's got to be, they've got to feel some emotion and some excitement and some passion for this building.
Boy, if I could just break into your house and get a copy of your tape library, I'd be set.
Oh, most notable wrestling matches I had an opportunity to call here, the Kangaroos, the fabulous Kangaroos wrestled here on a Monday night. And this was the late 70s, mid to late 70s. And Don Kent and Al Costello were in a tag team match. And I don't quite remember who they were taking on in that particular match, but Don Kent broke his shoulder in the match. Mm. And right in the middle of the ring, he broke his shoulder. And the professional that he was made the tag out to Al Costello, and Al Costello finished the match. By the time we got back to the dressing room, Don Kent's shoulder was the size of my head. It was huge.
Oh, man.
But that's just one of the, and of course, the World Tag Team Championships changed hands in this building. I think somebody said backstage over a dozen times. The World, NWA World Tag Team Championships right here in this very building. Siaki continuing to work on the masked man, the wrestler. Sent to the ropes. Back by big high one by Siaki. Look at that.
Now look at Fuller. Look at the expression, how his face has changed here.
Two count and almost a three. Siaki with that high lift on that back body drop, showing that upper body strength that this man has obviously been working on. And being of the Samoan background, you can see he has tremendous thighs and calf muscles that are very well toned. Sonny Siaki is a professional's pro, if you would, in professional wrestling. Look at this backslide. Siaki's shoulders are down, but only a two count again.
Just
very
two.
Close. Oh, super kick. That connected. That connected, and you could hear it all over this building. Siaki not quite as aggressive going after the wrestler, still slowed from that back body drop. Here's the count, one, two, and I thought he had him. Had he gone for that pin earlier, Dan, I think he would have had it.
I think you're right. You're absolutely right. And as you can see here now, Fuller's got the referee's attention.
Oh. And with that in mind, Siaki going for the abdominal stretch. He's going to take it, and he sets it in.
He's so close to that rope there. Look at this.
Siaki reaching out, maybe wanting to get a little more leverage, a little more pressure on the abdominal stretch, and indeed he does. Referee checking. Ropes are shaking, of course. Of course, Robert Fuller with that cane at ringside. Well, you know, you give Robert Fuller an advantage. Look at this. Siaki again using the ropes to his advantage. Big Mike, the referee, over to check. He's blaming the cameraman for shaking the ropes.
Mm-mm-mm.
Surprised he's not blaming Robert Fuller. Once again, referee's got catching this time from behind. Wrestler with that hip toss goes for the cover quickly. One, two, and oh, near count again for the wrestler. Siaki clotheslines the masked man down to the canvas. Here's the cover again, two, and so close but no cigar. Siaki may be a little frustrated in there in these near pins, Dan. He's getting so close but not able to complete the mission.
Still a young man, Siaki is, and he probably doesn't fully understand that sometimes it takes time to get a win. You can't just go out there and expect to knock this thing out quick, especially when you're in the ring with someone such as the wrestler.
And a veteran in there, and you're right, patience is a virtue in the squared circle. Back body drop. Wrestler coming up on Siaki. Boy, I'll tell you, the wrestler is showing a lot of prowess. I don't know who's under the hood, but whoever it is really proficient in that ring. Cover, one, two, and oh, I thought he had him again. Thought he had him again. Boy, we've got a big card of action coming up your way tonight on Wrestle Birmingham. What a great event this is. There's the wrestler coming up. Siaki rolls him over. You called it. Got the roll through. Got the win. Sonny Siaki victorious.
The winner of the match, Sonny Siaki.
That's what you get. You and my.
Accompanied at ringside, surprisingly tonight, by the stud Robert Fuller of the Tennessee Stud Stable. And Mr. Fuller, you have a smile on your face here tonight.
This man right here, Sonny Siaki, he's got an Alabama title. He's got the world championship written all over him. He looks like somebody. You know who I have to ask this fellow. Who do you think he looks like? I think he looks an awful lot like The Rock myself. This is a more handsome man than The Rock. I'm going to guarantee you this. Sonny Siaki's going to show Birmingham, Alabama great, great things in the future. Am I right, Sonny?
Give it a monkey. There's a new era. A new era. A new superstar in Wrestle Birmingham. And his name is Mr. Number One, Kaki Siaki. So to all the boys in the back, watch out, monkey.
We got lots more wrestling action.
I knew you was gonna step in there. We'll be right back.
Berry Productions, your source for technical management, staging, and sound and light systems. We'll deliver, set up, and make the magic happen, whether we're using our equipment or yours. We have a top-notch arsenal of sound and light systems that will make your next event sizzle and shine. And our highly professional staging services will have you up and running in no time and looking better than ever. With prices designed for your bottom line, you can't beat Berry Productions. 205-987-3211.
Where, oh, where are you tonight? Why did you leave me here all alone? I searched the world over and I thought I found true love. You met another and you was gone.
Back the truck up, boys. We're going to Nashville.
I'm a man, I'm a pro, and I'm better than you. I can bend you like a pretzel, I can tear you in two. I like to...
Ooh-wee, that was one heck of a fight between Bullet Bob Armstrong and gorgeous Jimmy Golden. Man, it was a loser-leave-town match. Let's take a look at it now.
Your next event of the evening is the main event. It is a loser-leave-town match. Your special referee for this match... Introducing first, from Montgomery, Alabama, he's a part of the Stud Stable. Being led to the ring by the Tennessee Stud, Robert Fuller. Please welcome Montgomery's own gorgeous Jimmy Golden. He's the patriarch of the Armstrong family. Please welcome to the Beltwell Auditorium, Bullet Bob Armstrong.
On the day I was born, the nurses gathered round, gazed in wide wonder at the joy they found. The head nurse spoke up, said, "Lead us alone." Right away, I was bad at bone.
Loser lead match here on Wrestle Birmingham. Michael St. John along with Dan Masters. Michael Christopher, our ring announcer, joins us. And before this match can break out, look at this. Brickhouse Brown goes right after Robert Fuller. Bob Armstrong on Jimmy Golden. Now, Brickhouse Brown is a special referee. The bell is rung. Here's Felix Skipper, Sonny Siaki.
What in the world is this?
Holy cow. Match could ever begin. The referee has no control whatsoever. Referee Brickhouse Brown being beaten in the corner. Boots put to him by Siaki.
I don't think the bell's gonna stop these guys.
Golden and McNasty. Fuller got out of the ring because Brickhouse Brown
went
right
after him. What in the world is this?
Fuller grabbing the chair of our timekeeper. No, sitting down, actually. I thought he was going after the chair. Right now, Brickhouse Brown pulled on it. Here come the rest of the Armstrongs.
We have lost control of this thing, Michael. This is just an uproar.
All the Armstrongs are in the ring. Jerry Stubbs is in the ring. He was a special referee tonight also. He's attending to Brickhouse Brown, trying to keep him from any further harm. Brickhouse really stomped in the ring. Armstrongs are on the floor. Bullet Bob and Jimmy Golden still in the ring. There's the sleeper. There's the sleeper on Jimmy Golden. Armstrong has the sleeper on Golden.
The referee is down.
Fuller is out in the chair next to us.
I don't know if I like this.
They're trying to get Brickhouse Brown out of harm's way. Jerry Stubbs, special referee, trying to call for some help. He's telling Scott Armstrong to help Brickhouse Brown. The Armstrong, Bullet Bob
Ladies
has
the
sleeper on
the
Golden. And now Jerry Stubbs helping Armstrong up.
Mr. Olympia,
now wait a minute.
Jerry Stubbs.
Armstrong telling Bullet Bob not to choke Jimmy Golden. Apparently he's trying to get some semblance of order in this match. Jerry Stubbs, special
wait a
referee.
Minute.
Wait, he now blocked Armstrong
Hold on.
From throwing the right hand. Fuller's back to his feet. Jimmy Golden, double axe handle behind Bob Armstrong. The Bullet.
Could this be
to the turnbuckle.
Bob Armstrong's final appearance in the Botwell Auditorium?
It's a loser leave town match. Jimmy Golden and Bullet Bob. Armstrong with a reversal. Golden caught him. Catches him with that kick. Cover two. Only a two count.
That was a fast two count.
By Jerry count. Jerry Stubbs, rather. Stubbs now being asked about that count by Armstrong. In the meantime, Golden.
Ooh.
Big chop by Armstrong. Another chop. Bullet Bob, right hand to the jaw. Hip toss, takedown, cover, one. Wait a minute, what's the count? Two, the count is very slow on this. A two count was all Armstrong got. And again, Armstrong questioning referee Jerry Stubbs, who is the substitute special referee after Brickhouse Brown was immobilized, if you would, by the studs table.
I hope the office of Wrestle Birmingham
is caught by Jerry Stubbs. Look at this. Jimmy Golden pounding an Armstrong being held by referee Jerry Stubbs. Brickhouse is coming back. Brickhouse is back. Brickhouse goes after the other referee.
Boom.
Remember, Brickhouse is the legal referee. Now he's going after Golden.
I've never seen anything like this in all my years.
Brickhouse Brown cleaning the house in the ring. Golden down. Stubbs, here comes. Here comes the Armstrong.
Here they are.
Siaki. Here comes Elix Skipper.
The stable.
And we're back to where we started.
And the Armstrong family all here.
Holy Toledo. They're all in the ring. They're out of the ring. Everybody around this ring. Fans are on their feet. Remember, this is a loser leave town match between Jimmy Golden and Bob Armstrong. They're battling it out. Golden is caught. Referee Brickhouse Brown. Now the Armstrongs have cleaned the ring again.
Scott Armstrong got a torn ACL.
Neckbreaker by Brickhouse Brown on Golden.
And he's even at ringside.
Brickhouse Brown now picking Jimmy Golden up. Here comes Armstrong off the ropes. Right hand, down goes Golden. Cover, one, two, three, that's it.
Michael, Jimmy Golden will never wrestle in this building again.
And that's it, Bob.
It's a celebration. It's party time here tonight.
I got something to say. I've been all my
Then Jimmy Goldman is gone, thank God, and Greyhound he's gone. Robert Fuller thought he had an ace in the hole, didn't he? He thought he had it done, but we won up them one time. Now it sounds like to me, somebody needs to be drinking on their haterade, because I'm gonna tell you something else right now, brother. When I told the Armstrongs the bullet wasn't going nowhere, and I'm coming over for Thanksgiving, I meant what I said. Y'all gonna have some collard greens, I know. Some chitlins gonna be in there, I know. Some jalapeno cornbread too, right? Now see, that's what I'm talking about. Now Robert Fuller, I want you to know one thing right now, brother. I told you a long time ago, you better back down before you get spat down. And when I smack you down, you better stay down. Cause one thing about it, brother, I'm gonna be out here every time you come out here to wrestle somebody, I'm gonna be in the other person's corner. Ain't gonna be no woman out here that squat the pee. You're gonna be looking at me, brother. Brick Hills! I'd like you to know the name.
That's all the show for tonight, and we need to get back to work. But don't forget, next week, right here on Channel 3340, more wrestling action. So until then, this is Larry Lloyd and my buddy Mad Jack from Wrestle Birmingham. Let's get started.
Take this job and shove it. I ain't working here no more.
That's all, folks.
I can bend you like a pretzel, I can tear you in two. I like to taunt you and scare you and make you feel lame. Cause in this business, that's the name of the game. I'm a big time wrestler and I like what I do. I destroy my opponent just to entertain you. I win or I lose by the count of three. But whatever the outcome, you can't defeat me. Jamming, I gouge, I take every advantage. I'll wind you like a spring, I don't care what your age is. You come to meet me, you better learn to fly. Cause you'll hit the mat hard when you come from the sky. Cause I'm a big time wrestler and I like what I do. I destroy my opponent just to entertain you. I win or I lose by the count of three. But whatever the outcome, you can't defeat me. Won't save you when I start my attack. If you try to escape, I'll just pull you back. I'll spin you like a top, and when you've had enough, I'll turn up the heat and really start to get rough. Cause I'm a big time wrestler and I like what I do. I destroy my